Hi, this is Chelsea from Ref and Write. In this video, we will see how to write the discussion section of your research paper. This is one of the most important sections of your research paper. This is where you interpret your results, highlight your contributions, and explain the value of your work to your readers. This section typically contains the following parts. It's a good idea to start this section with an overall summary of your work and highlight the main findings of your research. Then you must interpret your findings clearly to your readers one by one. Then you must talk about how your results fit into existing research in literature. Then you should talk about the implications and possible benefits of your research. Then you must talk about the limitations and shortcomings of your research. And finally, you can talk about the possible future directions of your work. Let's look at some examples. It is a good idea to start your discussion section with a summary of your work. The best way to do this will be to restate your research question and then remind your readers about your methods. And finally, providing an overall summary of your results. Look at this example here. This example is from an engineering research paper. The authors are restating their aims first, which is to compare different types of storm tracking software. Then they are providing a brief summary of the methods. Here they are testing different storm tracking software under different conditions to see which performs the best. Then they are finally providing their main finding, which is that they found software A better than software B. This is a very good example of how to start the discussion section by presenting a summary of your work. Here's another example. The authors are restating the hypothesis in the first line. They are saying that the aim of their work was to test the hypothesis that the type of learning method influences student achievement and grades. In the second line, they are providing information about the statistical test they used to test the hypothesis. Finally, in the last line, they are providing their main finding. They are saying that they found that project-based learning has a significant positive influence on student grades. As you can see, this paragraph pretty much summarizes the entire paper in three lines. The next step is to interpret your results. You have to explain your results clearly to your readers. Here is an example. This is a study that investigates the impact of different types of music on people. The authors are saying that their results show that there is a significant difference between pop music and classical music in terms of memory recall and cognition. Now they are providing their interpretation of the findings. They think it is because there is a link between the complexity of music and cognitive processing. They are also making a reference to a well-known theory called the Mozart effect to back up their findings. It is a nicely written passage, and the author's interpretation sounds very convincing and credible. Now look at this example. Here the authors are providing multiple interpretations of the same finding. This passage is from a paper about climate change. The authors are saying that their results show that the largest difference in ocean heat occurred between 1993 and 2021. Now they are providing their interpretation of the result. They are presenting two possible explanations for this finding. Number one, they are saying that this might be due to heat reflecting off the ocean surface back to space. And number two, this might also be due to an increase in greenhouse gases, which happened during this period. The authors believe that both interpretations are plausible and have explained them clearly in the text. The next step is to compare your results to the literature. You have to explain clearly how your findings compare with similar findings made by other researchers. Here's an example. The authors are saying that they found a link between exercise and stress reduction. Then they are saying that their findings are in agreement with most studies in the literature published on this topic. So, their findings provide further evidence of the link between exercise and stress reduction. As you can see, the authors have clearly explained how their results fit into existing research on the topic. Here is another example where authors are providing details of papers in the literature that both support and oppose their findings. The authors are saying that their results show that climate change will have a significant effect on the wheat production. Then they are saying that there are some papers in the literature that are in agreement with their findings. However, there are also many papers in the literature that disagree with their findings. This is very important. Your discussion should be two-sided, not one-sided. You should not ignore the literature that doesn't corroborate your findings. The next step is to explain to your readers how your findings will benefit society and the research community. You have to clearly explain the value of your work to your readers. Here is an example. In this paper, the authors are saying that their results show a strong relationship between childhood education and future career success. Then they're talking about the implications of their study. The authors are saying that their findings will help policymakers and educators make better decisions in the future. They're also saying that their findings re-emphasize the idea that investing in early education will have long-term benefits for both individuals and society. As you can see, the focus here is on the broader impact of the study. Here's another example. In this paper, the authors are saying that their findings indicate that artificial intelligence can be used to effectively manage wildfire events. Then they are talking about the practical implications of their study. They are saying that their work has proven that machine learning can be used to detect wildfires in real time. This is a great practical application and can save thousands of lives. As you can see, after reading this passage, you can immediately understand the value and significance of the work. It is very important that you discuss the limitations of your study. Limitations are flaws and shortcomings of your study. You have to tell your readers how your limitations might influence the outcomes and conclusions of your research. Most studies will have some form of limitation, so be honest and don't hide your limitations. In reality, your readers and reviewers will be impressed with your paper if you are upfront about your limitations. Look at this example. The authors are saying that the main limitations of the study are the small sample size and weak study design. Then they explain how this might have affected their results. They are saying that it is possible that they are overestimating the actual effect they are measuring. Then finally, they are telling the readers that more studies with larger sample sizes should be conducted to reconfirm their findings. As you can see, the authors are clearly explaining three things here. Number one, what is the limitation? Number two, how it might affect the study outcomes? And number three, what should be done to address the limitation? Here is another example. The authors acknowledge that their study has some limitations. Then they explain what the limitations are. They are saying that their experiments do not consider all problems that might occur in real-life situations. Then they explain how this might affect their research outcomes. They are saying that readers should be careful when generalizing the results to practical, real-world situations, because there is a possibility that the methods might fail. It's important to remember not to end your paper with limitations. Finish your paper on a positive note by telling your readers about the benefits of your research and possible future directions. Here is an example. The authors are starting the final paragraph of the discussion section by highlighting the benefit of their work, which is the use of biomass as a renewable source of energy. Then they talk about future research. They are saying that future research can focus on how to improve the sustainability of biomass production. As you can see, this is a very nice way to end the paper. I hope you found the presentation useful. See you in the next video. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you are interested in watching the extended version of this training course and learn more about research and academic writing, please visit our Learning Academy. You can find the link in the description below. If you still haven't installed RefnWrite software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write your research papers and thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. Finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now.